Hello dear friends, let's continue the game making series. In this video, we will learn sorting layer quickly. What is sorting layer? What does it do and how to use it? You should definitely use the sorting layer to make the game making process easier and faster. At the end of the video, we will set the sorting layers of our platformer game together. Okay, let's get started. I created a simple scene. This scene has a black background, green square, blue square, yellow circle and orange circle. And of course, there is the camera. As you can see, the sorting layers of all objects are default and ordering layers are zero. In this case, the object close to the camera will appear in the front. And the object that's far from the camera will appear in the back. So, the objects are sorted only by their distance from the camera. If the object is behind the camera, it will not be visible in the game. Only objects in front of the camera are visible in the game. The Z position of the camera is currently at 3.65. If the Z position of an object is less than 3.65, it will not appear in the game. In this case, the camera is usually pulled a little backward. If an object you added to the scene but is not visible, make sure it's in front of the camera. When we start the game making process, we usually don't create a sorting layer right away. We usually just sort using the ordering layer. If I want to bring the green square forward, I just need to increase the ordering layer. As you can see, the green square is now appear in front, even though it's far from the camera. If I set the ordering layer value of yellow circle to 9, it will appear just behind the green square. This is how the order is done using ordering layer. Let's say we add a new object to the scene. For example, I want the spike object to appear between the yellow circle and the green square. So the ordering layer value of the spike object must be between the value of the green and yellow object. So we have to look at the ordering layer values of the green and yellow object. Set the ordering layer to 12. As you can see, the spike object now appears between the yellow object and green object. As the number of objects in our scene increases in the following processes, this method becomes complex and difficult. At this point, the sorting layer becomes the game making process much easier and practical. Let's learn how to use the sorting layer. To add a sorting layer, click on default and then click on add sorting layer. As you can see, the tag and layers window have opened. Another way to open this window is to use the edit window. Click on edit window, select project settings, and then select tag and layers. But because it's usually faster after selecting the object, we click on the add sorting layer and create the sorting layer. As you can see, there is a sorting layer named default. To create a new sorting layer, click plus button. I will rename it to background. I will also create sorting layers named square, circle and spike. Okay, we have created sorting layers. Now I will assign these sorting layers to the objects. Select square objects and change sorting layer as a square. The top sorting layer is visible at the back, and the bottom one is at the front. We can change the position of sorting layers by dragging and dropping. If I take the background to the bottom, it goes in front of all the objects. Drag up the layer you want to appear in the back. Drag down the layer you want to appear in the front. You can also sort in the sorting layer. In the same sorting layer, the object with the higher ordering layer value appears in the front. Because the green square's ordering layer value is greater, it appears front of the blue square. Let's see the minimum value of order in layer. And let's see the maximum value. I wanna show you a simple example to better understand the logic of the sorting layer. I'll drag the square layer down, so I bring it to the front. And I'll increase the ordering layer value of the green square so that it appears in front of the blue square. As you can see, the green square is the farthest from the camera. However, it appears front of the all objects. The spike object is closest to the camera and appears behind the green square, even though the ordering layer value is greater than that of the green square. Because the sorting layer of the square object is in front of the layer of the spike object. Firstly, the sorting layer determines the display order of the objects. If the sorting layers are the same, the order in layers determines the display order. If the order in layer values are the same, their distance from the camera determines the display order. Let's say we add a new object to the scene. As you can see, the player object appears behind other objects. For example, let's say we want the player object to appear behind the squares, but in front of other objects. We can do this quickly using the sorting layer. So, I'll create a new sorting layer named player. Then, I'll drag the player sorting layer to the position I want it to appear. And then, select the player object and change sorting layer as player. As you can see, the player object appears behind the squares, however, in front of other objects. You can easily take the player forward or backward if you want. That's how easy it is to use a sorting layer. Let's go back to our platformer game making series and create the sorting layers together. First, let's start the game. As you see, dye particles spawns in front of objects. I will carry it to backward. We made the checkpoint system in the previous video. If you wanna watch it, you can access it from the cards. Also, videos about the lighting system and the moving platform are available on the channel. If you wanna watch, you can browse and subscribe to the channel. As you can see, the sorting layers of all objects are default. And we have sorted the objects using only the ordering layer. Let's create sorting layers according to the objects in the scene. Okay, we have created the sorting layers. Now let's assign these layers to the objects. Objects in our scene are not visible because light has disappeared. I selected global light and I'll change target sorting layers as all. Here, you can choose which layers the light will affect. I'll change the sorting layer of the wall as ground. I will leave the layer of moving platform and checkpoint as default. And I'll change sorting layer of the particles as particle. Okay, we changed the sorting layers of the objects. Now, let's arrange the order of the sorting layers. Start the game again. Let's bring the white screen to the front. Select white screen and I'll create a new sorting layer named front. Nice! I hope the video useful for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.